have with us Susanta Sarkar, PowerHF India Private Limited.
Thank you. Thank you for inviting me.
You said that you are providing power solutions to 35,000 telecom towers in India.
Yes.
Would you explain about your product?
We are primarily an engine manufacturer who is headquartered in China. We have got 3 factories in China, and our product range includes diesel engine, gas engine, diesel generator, and then going forward to an intelligent product which manages the battery, the rectifier and the DG set and the grid in a telecom tower, so that the diesel consumption becomes the minimum and the tower is mostly supported by grid and then by battery and then by DG. Further to that, in India we are a service provider also. We provide service to some 62,000 telecom towers as of today. In that, some 45,000 towers are of Reliance Jio, and for Indus, for American Tower, we provide services for both the active equipment as well as the passive equipment. When I say the passive equipment is basically this, the DG set, the battery and all this. And active equipment means what you see in the tower, the GSM antenna, the radio frequency products, all these things we provide services. We have got something around 17 offices in India with 800 plus manpower.
Towers are going green. So do you have also a green solution?
Of course. That is the reason that we had shifted from diesel engine to gas engine. And we had gone through the topography of India, and we could see that close to 150,000 towers in India has got the last mile gas connection. Gas, diesel engine and gas generator, there is a difference that for the diesel, you can buy the diesel from a petrol pump and bring it to the DG set. Whereas for the gas generator, you have to bring the gas up to the DG set. So the last mile connection is very important. So our survey shows that there are close to some 150,000 towers each, where the last mile connection is there, and it will be very easy to convert them from diesel generator to gas generator. In fact, we are working with a proposal with Indus Tower and Reliance Jio that their existing diesel generator, we are proposing them to convert it to the gas generator. So thereby like enhancing the green initiative of the government.
So with the conversion from diesel to gas, will that also help in removing the pilferage?
Of course. The pilferage will become zero because you cannot steal gas. See, when you use gas, there are a couple of advantages which are not a direct advantage. It's not correct that when somebody uses a gas engine instead of a diesel engine, your cost goes down per se for the consumption of the fuel. But as you correctly said, the pilferage becomes zero. Pilferage is a big amount. It's close to some 15-20% in India. That goes down. Then the pollution, the pollutant what comes out from a diesel engine, gas engine, it's not there. The carbon emission from gas engine is much, much lower. That is the reason we use gas in our home cooking. And the theft will not be there, the pilferage will not be there, the environment will be protected.
Any numbers that you are planning for gas generators?
We hope that we'll be able to do, I mean, we had been given some kind of a figure from the tower companies. But by taking a conservative estimate also, I think in the next 1 year, by the end of 2019, we will see at least something around 60,000 sites will convert from diesel to gas. And out of that, I'm expecting that we'll be able to cater to at least some 15,000 sites.
Thanks, sir. Thanks for talking to me here.
Thank you.